Today we are going to interview a girl named Sri Devi Vasudevan, and this girl is preparing for SSB here, and she has her SSB in April. I want to take an interview and show you a second one, maybe in April, where the overall improvement you will be able to notice in this girl, and that would talk about the training that we do here. So let's have this mock interview, at the end of which I would like all of you to comment on what do you think about this interview, what qualities she should be able to improve, and then I will tell you whether you have judged it properly or not within the comment section. So let's begin the interview. So I'll call Sri Devi. Please watch the full interview so that you are able to comment on her different aspects of personality vis-a-vis a SSB selection center interview. Okay, Sri Devi, please come in. Please have a seat, Sri Devi.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So, Sri Devi, the moment you enter, the interviewer is going to ask you a couple of questions just to make you slightly comfortable. So, please tell me, what is the meaning of your name? Because Sri Devi has been a very beautiful actress, and I didn't know what is the meaning of her name.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please tell me. You can remove your mask.
So the meaning of my name is Goddess Lakshmi. So
okay.
It's the another name of Goddess Lakshmi.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's begin with your education. So yes, tell me all about your education starting from 10th class onwards. Tell me which subject did you like most and which were the subjects you did not care so much about. Also tell me about your preparation for the 10th board. Where did you find difficulties and how did you sort them out? And what was the percentage that you got in your 10th standard? Also tell me which subject did you choose for your 11th and 12th and why? And tell me about your preparation for 12th board. What were the difficulties that you faced and how did you sort them out? By this time, you must have charted out some career goals for yourself. And tell me, how did you go about achieving those career goals? What did you do for your graduation? Which all competitive examination you appeared in? And what was their result? Also tell me about various activities that you participated in your school and college regarding sports and extracurricular activities. You may begin, Sri Devi.
Yes, sir. So, starting with my class 10th, I have done my schooling from Saga Public School, mm-hmm. which is a CBSE school at Bhopal. And I have studied since the year 2001, that is since class 1st. And talking about my class 10th, my favorite subject was English, and in science, biology. I love biology. And talking about the subject which I didn't much care about, I didn't care much about English language because I was quite comfortable with that language, and my teacher, Ms. Nivedita ma'am, she taught us very well. So I just had to prepare the chapters before the examination. So much efforts I hadn't put in that. So talking about my 10th result, yeah, I got
your preparation and the result. Yes.
Yes. So I prepared for the 10th board exam. Firstly, I prepared a timetable, and I divided the subjects, and for one day I used to do two subjects and divided the chapters. And I completed the syllabus 2 months before the examination. Then I started with my revision.
Were you as tense while preparing for your 10th board as you are tense now? You can open out. Yeah? Okay. Yeah. Please speak.
Yes, sir. So I prepared for the examination. But I attended coaching class also because I was little weak in science.
Yeah.
So I went for coaching class. For science.
When you say weak, were you weak in all the science subjects or just a few of them?
No, sir. I was finding little difficulty in physics and chemistry.
Okay.
I love biology, as I mentioned earlier.
Yeah.
So for that, I went for coaching.
Okay.
And for maths also, I attended the coaching class.
Yes.
And then I solved many question papers, sample question papers, the previous year question papers. And our coaching also, the teacher, she also supported us a lot. And I took help from my friends who were good in maths and science. So that's how I prepared for my 10th board. And I got 8.4 CGPA, that is around 80% in
that's
my...
That's good. Yeah, that's very good. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. So, talking about my 11th class, I was, I took commerce.
Okay, when you loved biology, why did you go on to take commerce as your subject?
So, because I liked biology, but I was finding difficulty in physics and chemistry. And also, it was my aim to go for a banking company. And, you know, commerce-related stuff I was more interested in.
Okay.
So, that's why I opted for commerce.
Okay.
Then in 11th, so as I mentioned, I opted for commerce. And then in 12th, for 12th board, I prepared for the examination in the similar manner like what I did for in the class 10th, like preparing for the timetable. And then I worked on it in a good manner. And then I also...
When you say good manner means how many hours of work were you putting in?
Around 14 hours.
Yeah, good, very nice.
Yes, sir. So, in that, I liked the subject in English and also business studies. I loved learning about business.
Okay.
And in that, I scored 88% and in English, I scored 92%. And apart from that, two pre-boards were also there. So, that's how I... got to learn about my weaknesses and I worked on my weaknesses, that weak areas. So, I kind of did a very good preparation for my 12th board. Then I solved many question papers and the mock question papers and also took the help from my accounts teacher as I was, I went for coaching for accountancy also. So, I took help from my accountancy teacher also, cleared all my doubts, everything.
Okay, so you went on to score about 82% in your 12th board.
No, sir. Overall, in 12th board, I scored 86%.
86%.
Yes.
Okay, very nice. Yeah, continue please. About tell me about your career goals and then what did you do in graduation and how did you achieve and what all competitive examination you gave,
yes,
about
sir.
Your preparation and your extracurricular activities.
Yes, sir. So, in graduation, I opted for BCom. I did my graduation from Sarojini Naidu Government College, Bhopal. And in graduation, I scored 71%. And for the talking about the competitive exams, which I appeared. So, I appeared for the banking exams and... banking exams and the IBPS, that is the IBPS PO and the SBI PO, and also I appeared for AFCAT once when during the last year of my graduation. And talking about my goals, since my subject was also commerce, so it was related to finance. I wanted to work in a financial institution like banks, so that's what was my goal. And talking about the extracurricular activities. So I was in the choir group of my school. I loved singing, and I also participated in many competitions, like the painting competition. I won first prize in the poster making competition. And talking about my college days, I participated in 200 meter race, and also I also participated in the solo singing competition. And many other events also. And one of the event was the WWF, that was the product launching and simulation competition. So that was a very interesting competition, wherein many the children were divided into many groups and of 10 members each. And
this was in college?
Yeah, during the post-graduation.
Okay.
So we had to make a product. We were assigned, three groups were there, and each group so three groups and one product was assigned. So we had to make one product, and then we have to give the presentation, promotion part, everything, right from the business idea till the selling of the product.
Okay.
So it was like that. So I thoroughly enjoyed in that, and yeah, that's
okay.
It.
So let's come to your family and friends. So tell me about your family. I can see that your father is an ex-army officer. So tell me about your father, about your mother, their education, their occupation now,
yes.
And about your any siblings that you have, about any relatives that are staying with you. Also tell me about your friends in your neighborhood and your friends in your school and colleges. What all activities you used to do with your friends in schools? What all activities you used to do with your friends in college? On an average, how much time would you spend with your friends in during school days, and how much time do you spend with your friends now in, when you're in the college? Also tell me about the characteristics that you like about the friend that you are closest with, and why do you like him so much or her so much?
Yes, sir. So, starting with my family member, there are four members in my family: my father, mother, and my sister, and me. So, my father is an ex-army officer, and he's currently working in a real estate sector as the head of operations. And he has, talking about his educational qualifications, he has done BCom and PGHRD. And my mother, she is a teacher at Sanskar Valley School, and she has done BSc and also B.Ed. And I have a younger sister who is currently pursuing her MSc from ITM Gwalior. So
that's about the family.
That's about
so
my
no,
family.
It's a nucleus family.
Yeah. Yes.
And your friends?
So my friends, starting from my school, I had many friends, but few were my close friends. Like one of my friend is Shatabdi. And she was my friend since class 2, and even she was there with me in my graduation also. Although her subject was different, but we were together
in
the same college.
Yes.
So we shared a very great relation and good bonding. And during the school time, we used to discuss a lot about the painting, artworks, because we both loved art. And
I thought you loved singing.
Yes,
because you didn't mention art at all. Anyway, continue.
Yes. So another friend is Sonam. She was there with me since class 8.
Yeah.
And she was my bench partner also. We used to sit together, study together. And even after class, we used to discuss about the topics and her weakness. So she was finding some difficulty in English language. So I used to help her. And she was good at accountancy.
Okay.
So she helped me in that. So we had a good relationship. Even in the BCom also, we
stuck together.
Yeah, yes, sir.
So was she living very close to your house? Because how you used to teach each other or help each other out in these studies?
So through firstly after the class and during the lunch time also, sometimes we used to discuss.
Okay.
And then we used to talk on phone only. So
okay.
That was because we stayed very far. So
okay.
That's why we used to talk.
So tell me about some characteristics of your closest friend that you like.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So she is very helpful in nature.
Okay.
So she is always ready to help. She is one call away, just one call away.
Okay.
So she was always ready to help me.
So tell me one instance when she went out of her way to help you out, and tell me one instance when you helped her or some other friend out of your way.
So, can I take a minute?
Yeah,
I
yes.
have to. So, during my school days,
yes.
I was not much prepared for my exam.
Okay.
So, even during...
This was in which class?
So, in 10th class.
In 10th class, okay.
So, I was not much prepared for my exam, and
okay.
I was feeling very low at that time. So,
okay.
Even during the late night, she talked to me, and she also explained me all the topics very nicely. So, I felt very good, and I could also do good in the exam also.
Okay.
So, that's how
I can see that from the result.
Yes.
Okay. And tell me one instant when you went out of your way to help some other friend. Yeah.
So during my post-graduation, one of my friends was not, it was my the presentation the next day, because in MBA we used to have lots of presentations and all.
Okay.
So she was not, she was not feeling that confident, and she was not she was struggling with the presentation also, as we joined new. So
okay.
even her computer knowledge was limited. So
okay.
so at that time I helped in making the presentation, as I told her to give the content.
Mm-hmm.
Then I made the presentation for her.
Mm-hmm.
And then sent it to her.
Okay.
And also helped in the presentation also, the explanation part also.
Okay.
So that's how I helped.
So we'll come to various sports and games in which you have participated while you were in school and college.
Yes.
And tell me how much time you used to devote for your sports and games in school and in college. And what all activities do you do nowadays to keep yourself fit?
Yes.
Also tell me about various extracurricular activities in which you participated in your school and college. And if you have any achievements there, or how much time you used to spend in extracurricular activities. Tell me about that competition wherein you actually launched a product. What was the preparation part of it? How did you prepare, and where did you learn to start right from the scratch of choosing the product and then advertising and then doing everything on this product?
Yes,
so you can start.
Yes, sir. Starting with the co-curricular activities, so I liked.
Doesn't matter. Continue.
Yes, sir.
Just talk. You don't have to answer the questions. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Just talk.
So, firstly, I want to tell about the sports with
okay.
Sports events which I was engaged in. So,
uh-huh.
During the school days, I liked badminton a lot.
Okay.
So, even during the games period, I used to play badminton.
Uh-huh.
And I also got a chance to represent my school
okay.
in class 9th.
Okay.
And apart from that, I have also played.
So when you say you got a chance,
yes.
Were you actually good at it, or had you practiced it, or they didn't find a girl so they said, okay, you come and play badminton for our school?
I was good at it.
Okay.
That's why
So tell me, how did you learn badminton? How much time you used to spend playing badminton?
So firstly, I played during my games period.
Period.
And
okay.
Then after that, I used to play after school time also, in between also sometimes I used to play.
Okay.
And our sports teacher, he taught us very nicely about
yeah.
the game. And also after when I got selected for that competition, so
mm-hmm.
we used to stay back after the school hours for practicing the game.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like that.
Okay.
And apart from that, I also participated in the 200 meter race.
Okay.
During my school days also, and also in my post-graduation also, I have participated
okay.
in 200 meter race.
Okay.
And recently, that is the last year, I participated in the infantry marathon, which
mm-hmm.
was held at Mau.
Mm-hmm.
I ran for 5 kilometers and I completed it. So it was a good experience for me, and at that time I was a bit new to running. I mean, I was not regular at running, so it was a great experience, learning experience for me. And apart from that, so that's all.
That's about
the
sports.
Sports.
Okay.
Yes, sir. And so about the other co-curricular, extracurricular activities. I have participated in many painting competitions,
mm-hmm.
and I also participated in the music competitions, many inter-school competitions also, and the patriotic song competition. And I earlier mentioned that I was part of the choir group also, so I used to sing regularly during the school assembly time also.
Okay.
And I also participated in the Bhagavad Gita chanting competition, which was held by Chinmaya Mission. And I won a consolation prize and also third prize in that competition. And yes, sir. Then apart from that, during my free time, I like to read books, listen to music, and I also like bird watching. So it's like I very much like bird watching, and I also love to go for trekkings and outdoor nature walks and adventure sports. So I like that a lot. So
tell me about one such adventure trekking that you did, where you had the opportunity to look at many birds of your liking. How did this come about? With whom did you go, and for how long did you spend on this trek?
So basically it was a bird survey. So okay. It is conducted by MP Forest Department yeah. every year.
Okay.
So for that actually the basic criteria for that is you have to know the basics of bird watching. That is you should identify the birds, or you are a birding expert, or you are doing some research in that field,
mm-hmm.
and you should be able to walk for at least 8 kilometers
right.
at a stretch. And mm-hmm. For that, I firstly attended a bird survey at Kearney Wildlife Sanctuary, which is in Devas district. So I went for we got an opportunity to walk inside the forest, and in that bird survey, actually many participants were there, and we were divided into many groups, and each group had a group leader, and also a forest guard was there. Since going in alone in the forest is not
yeah.
safe,
yeah.
So that day we went, and it was 2 days and one night, the bird survey. So in the morning, early morning, we left for the bird survey, and in the afternoon, around 2-3 p.m., we returned back for lunch, and then after lunch and after some rest,
mm-hmm.
then we again went for the birding,
okay.
So bird survey. So I could find many species of birds and identify many species. So it was a very interesting, a very good experience. And I was thrilled by the sighting of a Verditer flycatcher. It is a blue colored bird. And it basically comes from the Himalayas.
Okay.
And it is a winter
migratory.
Yes.
But, okay.
Yes, sir. So I was quite fascinated.
So Sridevi, coming on to that experience of selling a product right
yes,
from
sir.
The scratch.
Yes.
Tell me all about it right from the beginning.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So it was a competition wherein we have to sell different products. So three groups each were there, and around four products were there. I'm not able to recall how many products were there, but around four products were there. And our team got car washing shampoo.
Okay.
So and three teams were there who had to prepare on car washing shampoo,
right.
the product. So our team had 10 members, and we were allotted a mentor. So firstly, we planned about the product and what kind of we thought about the car washing shampoo, how it should be, and so for that we were also told about the different procedure or the steps which we have to undergo for that launching of the product.
Yeah.
So firstly, we made the we had to collect the information. So firstly, we had to study about the product, what exactly it is, and study the Indian market. And we had to select where we have to sell the product, and what all which all areas we have to sell and on which scale. Then we also thought about the product also, how it should be. And then we also we made a questionnaire about the product, since we had to know about the competitors also. So we had to get a real life picture what exactly it is. So so we went to different service centers, the car washing centers and all. We visited there and the car showrooms, and asked the questions. Our team, we went there and asked the questions and collected all the information of the questionnaire. Then after that, we then on the basis of the data which was collected, then we decided that we should go for a product which is meant for the firstly we thought about launching it in the state. Then we thought about the product, thinking about the limitations which were there. So then we planned about the product, and thought about its name, its features, and how many variants it should be there, and all those things. Then after that we
Coming from that product,
yes,
to something which you have been doing recently, for example preparing for SSB interview.
Yes.
Tell me all about your coaching for the SSB interview, And what were the difficulties that you faced during for in preparation of your SSB interview? And how were these difficulties resolved in the coaching?
Yes, sir. So, sir, for preparation of the SSB, I joined RS Defense Select Academy by Commander RS Rathore.
Okay.
So, under his guidance, I got to learn very lot about the SSB procedure, as I was not not completely aware earlier.
Okay.
I was having an idea, but after attending that, I got an idea about the procedures and what all things happen there, about the GTO tasks, and also I got a chance to witness it. Like, he sir used to conduct the mock interviews and all, so I got to learn how can we overcome our the weaknesses, and also then we used to have daily lecture aids and group discussions, which improved my confidence level also. And he helped us in becoming a better person and how to deal with the daily situations,
okay,
the daily problems of life, the effective intelligence. And in the GTO ground also, we had got an opportunity to learn about the individual obstacles and the group tasks. So,
did you actually practically do it? And
yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. I did it. Earlier, I was kind of scared,
okay,
initially, but
okay,
later on I started building confidence and I was able to do the individual obstacle. And then in the GTO also, the group task also, I got to learn new tricks and the basics of the how to deal with the how to place the plank and all those things about the
ideas in the PGT.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Sridevi, but he must have taught you that if you're going for an SSB interview and you tell the interviewing officer that you wanted to be a banker in your life, and when you're sitting there in front of interviewing officer, he's going to ask you if you qualify to be a banker, say a bank manager in SBI or the assistant bank manager in SBI through your PO exam, and you qualify for becoming an army officer through your OTA or FCAT entry in Air Force. Tell me, which career would you choose and why?
Sir, I would I like both the choices, because initially, yes sir, because of my commerce background, so I thought about it, but even I have a liking for the defense sector because I belong to a family defense background, so I had a liking and also wanted to be a part of the armed forces also. So I would go for being an army officer. That would be my first preference.
Okay, Sridevi, it was great talking to you. Thank you very much. And we'll take your interview again in April 2021.
Yes,
and
sir,
we'll see an improvement from here till then. Will you give me an improvement?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Sure.
Good. Thank you very much, Sridevi.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. You can go.